We're going to create this with Excel. It's an if statement and conditional formatting to determine if a date has expired. So let's get started. First, of course, we're going to need a column of dates, and we have it here in column B. We're going to find the expiration date. It could be for a carton of milk or when a membership was provided. And I have the number of days for it will be expired here in cell C1. I have it separate from the formula because if I decide I want to change it from 120 to 160, I can just change it here in this one spot and it'll populate throughout. And it's easier for someone working with the spreadsheet to know exactly where to make that change. So we're going to start with an equal sign, B3 plus C1. So we have here the expiration date for June 14th, 2022 will be October 12th, 2022. In order for us to populate the entire column with this formula, we need to lock down C1. And we can do that by entering dollar signs before the C and before the 1. But to do that quickly, you just click inside here and just hit F4. You'll notice it'll automatically enter dollar signs in this cell reference and then hit enter. And now we're going to double click on the bottom right-hand corner of the cell to quickly populate the entire column. So now we have the expiration date. Now the next step is to figure out today's date so we can determine if this record has expired. And you can do that by hitting the equal sign, type today, open paren, close paren, hit enter, double click on the bottom right-hand corner of the cell to quickly populate the column. As you can see, it's May 6th. It just simply reads it from your computer. And now for column F, the status. We're going to use an if statement and conditional formatting to determine if this record has expired. So we begin, of course, as usual, with an equal sign. Then if what? Is E3 less than or equal to D3? Comma to move to the next part of the formula. We're going to type, if it's true that E3 is less than or equal to D3, we want it to say it's active. And you can put in text as your outcome by surrounding it with quotation marks. Then we hit comma to move to the next part of the formula. Value if false. Let's say this statement is not true. What do you want it to do? We want it to print expired for, how many days has it expired? We can determine that by subtracting E3 from D3. But first, let's say you want to combine two bits inside the formula. In this case, we're going to combine expired 4 and E3 minus D3. And then close paren. All right, so it's active. So let's look a little closer at this formula and what it's doing. If today's date is less than or equal to D3, the expiration date, then we know it's active because it hasn't reached that date yet. And then here under expired for the false statement, if this condition is not met, then what do you want it to do? We want it to print out expired for how many days? It'll just inform the end user, okay, how many days has this been expired? So we figure that out by subtracting E3 from D3. Now again, we're going to double click on the bottom right-hand corner of the cell to quickly populate the column. And you'll see here we have a series of actives and some expired. So expired for 64 days, expired for 24 days. You know what? I think it'd be best if we say 64 days rather than expired for 64. So how can we do that? We can do that by clicking at the end here, adding an ampersand. An ampersand will combine bits of data within a formula. So ampersand with what? And a space, days, period, or no period, put a quotation mark, and then hit enter. So here we have it again. Expired for 64 days. We can pull this up. So we populate this one, then double click again to populate the entire column here in the bottom right-hand corner. So now we have expired for 24 days. You can combine as much as you'd like. Just stick an ampersand in there and just be careful with your spaces so it reads well. Okay, so now we're going to apply the conditional formatting so we can quickly see actives are set to green and everything else, expired, is set to red. So we're going to highlight column F. Click on the Home tab, which we are in right now. Pull down the conditional formatting menu. Click on Highlight Cells Rules. Click on Text That Contains. We're going to type in expired. We're going to keep it with light red fill with dark red text, then click OK. Pull down the conditional formatting again. Click on Highlight Cells Rules. Text That Contains again, and then type in active. We'll choose this default, green fill with dark green text, then click OK. So now you can see here, we can quickly eyeball what's active and what's expired. If you found this video helpful, please hit like and comment below if you would like any additional assistance with this formula, or if you have suggestions for future videos. I really do take them seriously, and I have created videos according to what people request. And hit that notification bell. It really helps the channel out. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.